2021 was a big year for Cardano. Why? The Alonzo upgrade saw smart contracts finally implemented on the Cardano ecosystem. There was mixed reviews on this. Some say it took way too long. Others thought it was worth the wait. Either way, Cardano is currently the fourth largest coin on CoinMarketCap. And projects on Cardano, they haven't gotten much media coverage. So this is what we're looking into today. Before we get into the video, I'm gonna stop.
Don't stop me now.
Did you guys know a massive 75% of you all that watch the channel are not yet subscribed? We asked Charles Hoskinson what he thinks, and he said this.
So it is what it is. Hi, Christ.
Not quite. We can actually get your help, and you can subscribe to make a big difference and help spread the word that we're making these videos to help educate you guys in the crypto space. So make sure to subscribe, turn on the notifications. Let's go. Here are the top 10 Cardano projects on 2022. So on the 12th of September 2021, Cardano fans felt a sigh of relief, a moment they'd eagerly been waiting for, but also Cardano naysayers didn't believe would ever happen. The Alonzo upgrade was rolled out and smart contracts finally went live on the network. Now, although Cardano is still such a few steps behind its more developed blockchain rivals in terms of decentralized apps, there are actually some really interesting reports showing that developer activity on the network actually overtakes the likes of Ethereum, Solana, and even Avalanche. So it is worth taking a look at some of the most significant dApps in the Cardano ecosystem and also how they could shape the future of blockchain. Let's go. API 3 is a Web3 platform connecting web APIs directly to smart contracts. Now, there are some similar functions to Chainlink, although API 3 brands itself as a first-party oracle, in contrast to different third-party providers like Chainlink. API 3 actually promises to deliver data more securely, more efficiently, and also transparently than its competitors. Its lightweight first-party data feeds these beacons that then connect to Web3 applications to off-chain data like crypto, stocks, commodity prices. One interesting point to note is that instead of relying on per-call payments, API 3 uses a really simple fixed subscription pricing model in its native API 3 token. API 3 plans to power different DeFi-related use cases on Cardano, like lending, stablecoin insurance funds, and even NFTs with this solution. Next up, we have ERGO, a decentralized exchange built by a team that also worked on developing Cardano itself, Chainlink, and Waves. This isn't the respect of Charles Hoskinson, Cardano founder himself, who actually called it one of the most revolutionary cryptocurrencies ever built. Pretty big statement, so we're gonna look into it. The ERGO DEX uses automatic swaps, therefore eliminating the need for token wrapping and gateways, and allowing the exchange to function without centralized intermediaries. This also enables ERGO to offer other features like limit orders that are usually reserved for centralized exchanges. The platform offers the option to store coins for a long-term storage fee, and these are specifically for coins stored longer than 4 years. Coins moved once every 4 years are not subject to this fee, and coins lost can slowly be recovered over time. ADAX is a decentralized and non-custodial liquidity protocol that actually allows users to trade their coins without giving up control of them. Here's what I mean. By trading against an automated market maker, ADAX actually removes an order books model of complexity and time-consuming features while still providing users with the liquidity to execute substantial trades. ADAX plans to release the version 1 of its exchange this quarter and really envisions NFT swaps and ERC20 bridge as part of its future development plans. So this could be one to watch. Now it's one for the NFT users out there. THEOS is a smart liquidity protocol for NFTs, providing a decentralized, creator-based financial ecosystem on the Cardano blockchain. It's backed by some influential heavy hitters in the entrepreneurial space that include Matt Sorum and Dirk Alborn. Now THEOS, it vows to provide the ultimate solution for a non-fungible and also a fungible multi-token environment. Users can mint NFTs with a simple drag and drop tool and use their NFT to create liquidity protocols, allowing them to borrow against the NFT as collateral. Next up today, Ardana is a stablecoin ecosystem integrated with Cardano. Its DUSD stablecoin is backed by collateral, allowing investors to leverage their ADA and also borrow against it, utilizing a similar mechanism to MakerDAO. So as a user, you can actually mint new DUSD by providing ADA as collateral. Its Dana Swap decentralized exchange is designed for multi-asset pools, meaning you as a user can swap between stablecoins and also other assets with really low slippage. And this is where it gets interesting. Actually, on top of that, Dana Swap features a foreign exchange service where users can swap their stablecoin between different currencies like DUSD, DEuro, and DGDP. Perfect for travel. On the DeFi side of things, we have Occam.Fi. This is a suite of decentralized financial solutions for the Cardano ecosystem. This provides really important DeFi infrastructures like DEX tools, liquidity pools, and launchpad capabilities. Occam's flagship project is a decentralized funding platform called OccamRaza, which actually acts as a launchpad for DeFi projects on Cardano. And some pretty notable projects have launched on OccamRaza, such as MeowSwap, which is a DEX, Nazha, a blockchain-based liquidity engine for prediction markets, and WeCrypt, a decentralized mobile internet sharing network. So this already has some use case already. Charlie3 is another decentralized Oracle solution that plans to pull data from APYs and hash them on-chain to provide data streams to protocols. Where we're at currently, Charlie3 has incorporated price feeds on the public Cardano testnet and also has a working node reputation list that ranks data providers according to their trustworthiness. In the near future, Charlie3 plans to expand this ranking by allowing data providers to stake its native C3 token and also back up data reliability through a proof of stake consensus mechanism. Next up, MELD is a decentralized protocol that incorporates fiat loan capabilities into the crypto ecosystem. In other words, MELD provides a run-of-the-mill DeFi capabilities like lending and borrowing in crypto, but without the need for KYC. Its service involves creating a fairly standard financial product like under-collateralized debt positions with a to-loan value ratio of 50%. Now, you as a user can take out a loan with 50% of the collateral value, and if the loan total value reaches 85%, the collateral is then liquidated, and users receive their outstanding position minus a liquidation fee of 5%. Now, our next two on the list make it here, but there has been some buzz around the community recently. SundaeSwap is a native decentralized exchange, but also a liquidity provision protocol. And it's quite interesting because it promises DeFi functionalities like staking, borrowing, and also lending. This means that it works similarly to protocols that are also seen like Uniswap, but it also functions as a native Cardano solution. So what does SundaeSwap promise? Well, its main objective is to democratize the ownership of the profits, make it really, really efficient for you as a user, and also offer liquidity provisions and the effective empowerment of Cardano's DeFi ecosystem. Now, given that its IDO has actually been delayed multiple times, there are some lofty goals here which the exchange will have a hard time delivering on, especially as they face problems with token swapping from ADA all the way through to Sundae. So SundaeSwap now started speaking with one of our next projects about how they could work together. SundaeSwap and CARD.STARTER actually entered into a marketing and collaboration agreement in June 2021, and there has been some updates since. So next up on the list, we have CARD.STARTER, our final Cardano blockchain project for today, a decentralized accelerator and token swap platform that connects early stake innovators with investors. Projects that are part of the CARD Accelerator program have access to a range of services like token engineering, security audits, and also support for social media and branding campaigns. Now, here's something I want to share. Token holders actually receive early access and guaranteed allocations to seed rounds and pre-sales. And developers, they can also benefit from unlocking a pool of trusted and vetted investors. All the projects that are on the platform actually manage to contribute to the token's insurance treasury, which provides investors with financial protection against the project's failure. As I mentioned earlier, CARD.STARTER has been in the news lately, and developers signed an agreement with SundaeSwap, the last project we discussed. And while the outcome of this agreement is still pending between the two projects, I wanted to bring you the pros, but also the cons of what's being built. Now, I do want to turn to you guys and ask you, which of the 10 projects stood out for you? Are you a Solana blockchain kind of guy? Did Cardano pique your interest? Or is there another project or protocol which you're looking into? Share your thoughts with me in the comments. And if you do have any more questions about this wild world of crypto, you can always ask Alex in the description box below. Hey, so you just watched a brand new CoinMarketCap episode. I hope you learned something new. And if you do want to see more, just watch one of these videos here and definitely subscribe to here. If you want to help us out on the journey of making cryptocurrencies adopted by all around the world.